So we're on our way to Washington for Paintball Extravaganza. As you can see, I'm sitting with Matt and Zuby. Far more facial hair in one row than they allow, but some reason they're letting us do it. And in front, Joe's working on knitting a scarf, so hopefully we'll have it done before we get to Extravaganza.
Hey guys, and welcome to Behind the Bunker, episode 100 and something here. We are live at Paintball Extravaganza. Woo. Nice. We are joined tonight with this live studio audience. My name is Todd Ansich, guys. I am your host here, as I am every week for Behind the Bunker. Thank you for tuning in tonight. Tonight is a special live episode, as I mentioned. We are still in Leesburg, Virginia, at Paintball Extravaganza. All the vendors are now at home, snug in their bed, and all the vendors are gone, but we are left with all kinds of footage that we want to show you guys this week. And in the studio with me, I have, as always,
Joe Kimson from Flaggeter's Paintball.
Very nice. And Josh.
Josh Zubizabrikas.
That's now the Josh Zubizabrikas.
That's my trademark.
Yes. Yeah. Now, as I mentioned, we are live tonight, so we have a small studio audience this evening. Can we say hi to those guys?
Hi, guys.
Very nice. Welcome, welcome. Now, A-Train, let's do a mic check. Is he on live? Very good.
One, two.
Welcome Bob Barker this evening. He is taking care of our studio audience. Who do you have in your studio audience? Let's see who's out there.
It looks like we've got Mad Frog, and from Behind the Bunker, and Blues Crew, Beaker, and Exiled Souls. Jay Crook from Mad Frog. Sarge, a great friend of the show from the Paintball Weasels. Miss Sarah, and Michael.
Now, Michael travels, he wins the farthest distance traveled award.
Right. Michael, where are you from?
Brazil, South America.
Outstanding. And what organization are you with?
Mega Jogo. We make the biggest paintball game in Latin America last year with 1,050 players in the scenario and over 100 and something players in speed. We mix speed with scenario.
Oh, fantastic.
Very
so
nice.
We'll
very nice.
Michael.
Very nice. Well, we've got a lot on the show tonight to get to, and we'll get back to A-Train in his studio audience very shortly. As I mentioned, guys, Josh, myself, Joe, and everybody that you've seen here have been working diligently all week trying to get as much footage as we can to show you guys all the new products and stuff. Right off the bat, we're going to get going because we have a ton of videos to get to now. The biggest, hottest item we're going to start with has been the Vanquish. It's been teased for quite some time. It's been the hottest release. It's also probably the most expensive marker and the most highly sought after.
I would say so.
For sure. Yeah. So we're going to start with this. This is a quick interview that we did with Travis at Key, so check it out.
Hey guys, Todd Ansich from Behind the Bunker here at Paintball Extravaganza Live 2013. I am in the Empire booth with my friend Travis Lemansky. We have a new toy that we want to show you. Heard a lot about this. This has been on all the press releases. This is the new Vanquish. What do you say? Tell me a little bit about this. This is the new shiny red Vanquish, as I see.
It's actually atomic orange, Todd.
Oh, my mistake. My mistake. But no, it does look a little red under certain lights. But, you know, it's like my hair looks weird under certain lights.
That's right. That's right. I like to keep it infamous orange.
Canada red.
Whatever. So I'll give you the basic bullet points of this gun. Has a balanced pressure inline reg.
Very spools. Nice. Very similar to how the axe detaches.
Very similar. Turn the gun on right here. It's got a big wide screen. You can see the laser eyes inside there. It's 2 and 4 eye compatible. It comes with 2, but it is a 4 eye compatible. Turn back in. Comes with a full 5-piece insert super freak kit with a carbon fiber tip.
Very cool.
My favorite part of the whole gun is it comes with 1 Allen key, right? So a 3/32 Allen key will do any piece, even like the little adjustments on the trigger, same Allen key. You want to tighten down your bottom line or get to the eyes, whatever it is, same Allen key. The hottest feature on the gun right now, you can zoom in on that little tiny screen, you'll see it says low PSI. When you plug a tank in, it'll give you the actual input pressure of your tank. So it'll say
that's great.
174 PSI, 180 PSI. You can tweak the velocity right there. It's accurate. 1 to 3
and
PSI.
And I'm glad you said that because I am damn sick of dial gauges. I want to know down at the digital how much is in my tank. So that's cool.
Yeah, you can shoot a stream and see how if you're beating down or you're just on point. So So that's the nuts and bolts of it.
Very cool. And I want to show you this too, guys. Look inside there, the nice blue brake beam eye sensor. Very cool. So guys, check that out. Now, when are these going to drop?
We're saying 6-1, right? We want to keep expectation levels reasonable, but it could be sooner.
For sure. But this is my new gun for this year, guys. This is the new 2013 Vanquish from Empire. Check it out.
All right, guys, so that was great. That was the new Vanquish from Empire Paintball. Let's go to our studio audience. Do we get a thumbs up or a thumbs down on that product?
What do you think, studio audience? On the Vanquish. We have three halfways.
I need to play with it a little bit.
Yes, when you play with it, it'll yeah.
Okay, well, we're told that it's a two thumbs up by many.
Very cool. So time will tell, guys. We're going to see that in the stores very shortly. When we do, we'll see how it goes.
I think it goes pew pew though.
Very good. Now, Joe.
Yes.
You're wearing a hat today.
I am. Our good friend and good promoter of paintball generally, Mark Pagan from Help Keep Paintball Live, knows that I'm Canadian. Knows that I'm a big fan of Tukes.
Mark's watching at home. It's Pagan.
Mark
Pagan. I corrected
Pagan.
Him.
Yes.
Very nice.
Mark Pagan, a big fan of paintball, Help Keep Paintball Live, gave me a toque because
sure.
of my toquey goodness.
Oh, sure. So we're going to promote him, Help Keep Paintball Live. Check him out on Facebook, guys. He does a lot of great things and has a lot of great content. So check him out. But speaking of great content, we're going to move on. We have lots of videos to get to tonight. I find my long-lost uncle here at the show. Check it out. We'll be right back.
Hey guys, Todd Ansich for Behind the Bunker. We are still live at Paintball Extravaganza 2013. I am in the Bob Long booth, as you can see, with my long-lost uncle, Bob.
How you doing, guys?
Bob, what do you got new this year in fun?
Well, we came out with a gun called the VCOM. What the VCOM is means Victory Changeover Motor. We have taken this gun, we can use it as a poppet valve gun, and then the guys that want to change it, all they do is replace the motor, and it's a spool valve. Very simple, it can go either way. It's the only gun in the world that can fire as a poppet valve and a spool valve. So we've really got new technology coming. We get great gas consumption, about 1,500 shots out of a spool, about 2,200 shots out of a poppet. So, you know, gun doesn't wiggle. Really, really good job.
For sure, for
you
sure.
We've got a lot of new things coming out this year. Watch out, we swung at the fence this year, so you'll get to see it. There's new things every month or so.
Cool. All right. Check it out, guys. I caught Zuby. He's reading the Tantra. 50 Shades.
Any new positions, Zuby?
Don't you mean the Kama Sutra?
I'll tell you about it later.
Zuby's reading the Kama Sutra.
Very good. So awesome. Very cool. Now, guys, one thing I want to remind you is we have a live Twitter feed just underneath your screen there. Twitter in what your responses are, your thoughts are on some of these new guns, and we'll post it up. It's at Behind the Bunker, much like the Grammys when you're watching or the Super Bowl, but
or the Oscars.
Yeah, but on a slightly smaller scale. But
very smaller.
Yeah. So yeah. Why don't we?
But it's
yeah.
It's great. If I hear
look
that
at that. We're 15 minutes, not even 15 minutes in, and Zuby's already got me on it. So again, we got lots of great new stuff coming up tonight, and this next video that Joe did was a video that or a product that doesn't even have a name yet. We named it
the T15, but
yeah, so check it out and see what you guys think of this.
Hi guys, Joe from Behind the Bunker back here at Paintball Extravaganza 2013. I'm with Owen and Simon. We're at the Tiberius booth, and they're going to talk about jointly the new Tiberius 15 T15.
I think they just made that name up for it. I don't think it's even been named yet.
Yeah, it's too new to have a name. But it's what are you most excited about here, Simon?
I think in terms of realism, I've never seen anything come close to a real AR-15 as this does. It's even down to the interface. This is a real AR shroud. This is a real AR stock. This is a real AR grip. As realism goes, it doesn't get much better.
I mean, what I'm excited about is this mag. It's a mag-fed marker. Actually held 20 paintballs or 19 first strike rounds in a loop. And I'm really interested to see how they made that work. That's
There's
a real
something
innovation.
Fancy going on here, uh-huh. but we can't see inside yet. But there's something very special going on inside this magazine that I think is going to be pretty revolutionary to people shooting first strike rounds.
And you can't deny that the optional hopper built into the dust cover on the
cool.
on the AR, it's so realistic.
Very cool. You even have the same cocking system as on AR. You have a forward assist that's a dummy, but it moves. And you also have on this the twisting barrel system that allows you to change from magazine fed to hopper fed. So you have those options. I believe there's actually another dust cover that if you only want to run mag fed, you can take this off, put it on it, and that there is nothing more realistic than that.
Yep. All around, I mean, we're very excited about this. This is it's a great product. Can't wait to get it to Canada.
And they also have the ability to run the gas system through the bottom of the grip frame or run it in stock.
That's right.
So you can actually put a tank on or a remote line hose or build it into the stock as well, the small capacity tank. It's impressive.
Yeah, pretty awesome, guys. That's the T-15 from Tiberius, their new mag-fed scenario training weapon, etc. So watch behind the bunker.
What's up, everyone? Steve Rabikoff with GI Sports. And I got some friends walking by here. Watch behind the bunker, Booyakasha.
Hi, we're back. Nice photo bombs. It's actually a video bomb. Used to be photo bombs. Now it's video. As we progress, then soon we'll have no more video. We'll be doing something else. So we'll be whatever teleport bam.
Now bombing. That gun that we just saw is right up your alley.
It is. It's right up my MagFed alley. Both Milo and Parker are MagFed. Haha. Wolf gets it, but no, maybe even Simon. But anyway, that was pretty awesome. I saw it. It was, the booth was literally right across from us, 8 or 10 feet away the whole time, and it just sort of miraculously appeared through this haze of convention vapor. And I went over and I said, "Wow, this is cool." And I showed, and then Owen saw it, and he came over, and Simon, and the thing is really, really well done. I've seen a lot of real steel, and this had a lot of components. It was heavy.
I watched these.
I'm not a porno.
I watched these three guys literally having a sword fight over this gun. It was, they were all very excited.
It was a Milsim geek out.
But you got to realize this gun, aside from
the marker,
well,
that's a gun. It's more of a gun.
Well, the reason why I say that is this gun is virtually made of all real gun parts. It's mostly interchangeable. The only thing different is the barrel size, the bore size.
But the lower receiver's the same. The grip's the same. They had a tactical one with Picatinny rail shroud on it. It was Daniel's defense, legit. Like this thing is cool. And I think it's gonna not revolutionize paintball, but it's gonna, guys that have left paintball to go play airsoft are going to sell their airsoft and come back and start playing paintball because this 19 round mag will fit in them 30 round mag things. It's cool. It's really cool. Yeah.
So we're going to move on, guys. We're going to give Zuby some
love. Can
we
talk about it longer?
No, maybe tomorrow.
It's my love time.
Zuby, as you know, used to be a lumberjack and enjoys a lot of the wood. And he was walking down one of the aisles and saw this vendor and thought he would do a feature video. So check this out.
Pretty good.
What's up, everybody? Zuby here from Extravaganza 2013. I'm at Concord Paintball checking out the new digs. Look at this bucket. Look at this. Actual wood. Think steel, real weight of an AK, it's fantastic. Plus, not only this, just we've got folding stock, the classic and ever rare paratrooper stock. You've got your rails, your tack light, the whole deal, your slings, all set up. Looking legit. Watching behind the bunker.
Okay, guys, so I'm at Paintball Extravaganza, as you know, and I am now at the Deadly Winds booth. With me, I have Brady. Brady, how are you today?
Doing pretty good.
What do you have for us for Deadly Winds this year?
Well, we brought our normal run of products. We have our fiber barrel that's uses freak inserts with a carbon fiber barrel. We've had that one out for a pretty good while now. We've also had the Null barrel out now. It's a straight bore barrel that we just went for a little lower price point. This one's just below $60. But it's a straight bore barrel, and it's the lightest barrel in the world right now. But our newest product we have is what we're calling the Fiber X. And what it does is add to the fiber barrel. It still uses freak inserts, so you can pull them out. But we also have interchangeable backs on this. It's a reverse thread, so you have to remember to turn it backwards.
Now, does dropping it help?
Dropping it is required every time you take it back. I do that every time.
Very good.
So we have three different thread types that you can put on the same barrel front currently. We have two more thread types coming out, so we're going to have about five, maybe even six threads eventually by the time we're done.
Very cool.
So this X is our latest, greatest barrel.
Very cool.
Now, one thing I want to say is I showed this once before, but this is still one of my favorite products. This is the carbon fiber tip for the Apex 2. So check it out, guys. Deadly wins. So here we are at Chick-fil-A. This is Zuby's first time ever hitting a Chick-fil-A. What did you think?
It's pretty good.
New sponsor?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
It's no Waffle House.
Yeah, it's no Waffle House.
All right, so good video. That was Josh's first roving report. We have a few more of those coming up today.
Josh's first time in Washington and also his first time at a paintball trade show and his first time seeing much sought after and talked about D-Mag. Mm-hmm. And
Joe and Zuby shared a suite last night, and it was a first time for a lot of things. Now, why don't we move on to our studio audience, A-Train.
Yes, sir.
How is our studio audience doing tonight?
It's growing.
You guys enjoying the show?
Very nice, very nice. All right, now, guys, I have to tell you, this next video is something that I knew that was coming up a few months ago. This is something that I've been waiting for. I've been a big fan of this. No one knew about it until basically the day of the trade show. Key Empire did a really good job of keeping this one secret. I know Joe and I are super excited about it. Zuby, maybe? A little bit.
Are you kidding me? Come on, seriously?
Zuby's excited. It's pretty awesome. It's very revolutionary.
It's no mag. But check this out, guys. This is something cool.
Hey guys, Todd Ansich here, back for another edition of Behind the Bunker. We are at Paintball Extravaganza Live 2013. I gotta be honest with you, I've checked out the entire show. I've been around this thing a couple of times, and I've seen a lot of great products from a lot of different companies. We've seen the Vanquish from Empire, we've seen all these other great products, but you know what, there's only one that's sticking out right now that's giving me that tingling warm sensation. This is a gun that I loved from years before. I've always been an autococker guy, and now they've done it. They've come out and rebranded it and redid it, and this is the 2013 version of an autococker. This is fantastic. Travis, tell us a little bit about what you've done here with this.
All right, so obviously we haven't had an autococker in quite a while.
Sure.
Last year, we launched the Sniper, and it was a cool project. We were all kind of behind it. There's actually a handful of dudes behind it. Well, it was very successful for us. You know, a lot of people liked the gun. We had a lot of good hype, and you know, one of the resounding things was, hey, when are you bringing back the autococker? And I think this guy was one of those. But so this is based off the Sniper platform, but it is a full-on autococker, right? It has all the upgraded front end, mid-block. It's got the classic slide frame, single trigger, integrated on-off. Comes with a full five-piece sniper barrel kit, which if you haven't checked those out, they're amazing. You want to see a control bore? Check that out. So
won't be snapping that off when you do a core sample in the ground. Now, I see that you have this. You have the three-way, you have the LPR, the RAM like you would normally on a gun. Can I take an old LPR that I have and put it on it?
Yes.
Can I take an old RAM that I have and put on it?
Yes. Yeah, so if you have an old rock regulator or some other thing that you're super attached to, you can upgrade the front and it'll mount right in there just like a old stuff did.
Sure. This is great, guys. For those of you that may not know much about an autococker or are new to the sport, For those that used to shoot them all the time, you'll know this has the best trajectory, best, most accurate gun I've ever fired. It's always been an autococker. So when I play recreationally, this is what I'm going to be checking out. So guys, I'm going to continue to drool over this. This is the new 2013 autococker.
Hi guys, Joe from Behind the Bunker. We're here at Tiberius Paintball Extravaganza, holding a first strike round. I know a lot of you have different opinions and ideas on first strike rounds, but this is one of the standard first strike rounds. Tiberius has come out with a limited edition first strike round. It is the 300 caliber first strike rounds. This is designed to go into a howitzer. It'll fly straight. It'll take out a paintball tank without a problem. You can use it to take out entire buildings, even villages. There is talk of a nuclear tip to go on this, or even a large paintball grenade tip. So these can be used for the games, the start of a game. It could go in a mortar right into a landing craft, taking a whole thing out, take a whole village out. So these are new Tiberius 300 caliber first strike rounds. Cool, you saw them first here at Paintball Extravaganza.
How you doing, Nick? Nice to see you here at Extravaganza. Zuby, nice to see you, buddy.
Hi.
J-Rob, hey, buddy, how are you? Good? Yeah, good. That's awesome.
All right, so guys, I got to say, at first glance, you might not be too excited, but you got to realize this is a brand new autococker, fresh out of the box, nicely designed, nice and light, comes with five backs. Well done, good job by Empire Paintball on rebranding that. I think it's going to be great. And what are they calling it? The
Resurrection
Autococker.
It comes in two colorways, the same colorways as the Sniper, but there's also black on black. Yes, so, I don't have a bell. I'm bellless, so I'm very limited on my ability. I'm very limited on my ability to ding. However, I will create situations that require dinging to be done by them.
Very good.
3 D's.
All right, guys, I want to remind you guys tonight and thank our sponsors. Without our sponsors, we would not be here. I want to thank Empire Paintball, Arups Bunker Systems, Falcon Paintball, Dye Paintball, Patchworks.
Yes, thanks.
And Paintball Extravaganza. If it wasn't for them helping us out, we would not be here. We'd be sleeping somewhere outside in a tent. So thank you very much. So we have
a
lot more to get to this evening. Why don't we move over to one of our California friends and see what they released this week.
Hey guys, Todd Ancich here, back for Behind the Bunker. We are still live here at Paintball Extravaganza 2013. I just ran into my friend Billy Wing. Billy's going to show us he has a couple new things with the DM13 for the season.
Yeah. Hey guys, so yeah, we're here, got the DM13, we did 3 color spring releases for the DM13. In my hands I got the red and blue, kind of like a Superman looking gun. Nice polish.
Or Captain America.
Captain America, yeah. Trying to be a little more patriotic, I guess. But is there anything? Superman's pretty all-American, so either way. But also in the case, you'll see they got the red-orange cubics and the dye tree camo. It's the DM13, just, some updated colors, keep the gun fresh, looking good, keep you guys looking good on the field, that kind
of
thing.
Sure. So if you haven't had a chance to pick up your DM13 yet, now you have 3 more options. And these aren't going to last, these are limited edition,
limited
right?
Limited edition, it's a spring release, so we only do about two runs of each colorway, maybe about 50 or so of each colorway, so they are going to go quick. Being here at the Extravaganza, the orders from the dealer's going to come quick, they'll be on the showroom floors by the end of this week.
For sure, so make sure you hound your local stores and see if they can get them in for you. Awesome, thanks Billy,
and
we'll look forward to see more new stuff from Dye.
That's good, thanks.
You're watching Behind the Bunker!
All right, so that was pretty cool. So we were talking about the DM13, and what do you think of the new colors?
Yeah.
Pretty nice. I like them.
Pretty cool.
Some of the PGA are pretty, not the Pro Golfer Association, but the way they've done some of the different colorways with matching hoppers, it's nice.
Yeah.
And you can really dress them up, as I say all the time, with a nice set of pearls.
Yeah, for sure. Why don't we go to our studio audience and A-Train?
Yes.
Why don't we talk to some of the people in the studio audience and find out what their favorite item that they had seen this week was.
Fantastic. Matt Frog, how about yourself? You were here for all 3 days, correct?
Correct. It was a good show. Good show. My favorite thing, I think, or something that stood out at the show was the RAT4 simulator. They had a
Tell us about that.
They had a really cool setup, really nice design. They had a laser pistol that you could shoot at moving simulated targets.
I shot at it.
Yeah, it was pretty cool. And then they also had it where you could use like a reball, and it had a thermal sensor, so it felt the impact
I
on
did
the
that.
Screen, and that's how it registered a hit. It was pretty neat. It was pretty neat, real life simulator. And I think other people in the audience here liked it as well as
the I parent. Tried it.
Yeah. Nice. Well, we'll check around and see what other ideas we can come up with.
Very good. A-Train, when he's not interviewing our studio audience, is also a lawyer on People's Court, as you can see with his badgering the witness questions there. But well done, sir. Well done. Why don't we move on? We have a couple more videos. We're going to go and see our friend Edward R. Evans from Exalt Paintball next and see what he's got new.
What's up, Behind the Bunker Land? Zuby here.
Paintball Extravaganza 2013. I'm with my new friends from Exalt.
How's it going, guys?
And what are we looking at today?
What we have here is our team microfibers. These are a dual-sided microfiber. We have all of our Exalt colorways here. Basically, the idea is you got carabiner clips, you walk off the field, and maybe you got gogged by Zuby, and you can walk off, you can clean them off, use the gray side first, then use the graphic side. And we've also got these available for customization. As you can see here, we've got an event. These guys are using them as prizes, so maybe if you check out this tournament series, you can win some cool prizes if you happen to get first place like Zuby here. So check those out, go to xlpaintball.com, and we've got lots of cool stuff coming.
Hey guys, Todd Ansich here for Behind the Bunker. We are at Paintball Extravaganza 2013. I'm in the JT booth with my friend Junior Brown from Sacramento Excessive. Junior has a new gun he'd like to show us. Up till now, all we've seen is some teaser pics. Well, here it is, guys. This is the JT Impulse.
Hey, this is it, guys. Zoom in nice and close. Comes in five colorways. We have this color, the blue and silver, black and red, red and black, and black and black. Features of this gun is the nice OLED display on the back for you there. Toolless clamping feed neck, two-piece barrel, bleed AS on and off. Fantastic gun. XS has been testing it since before World Cup 2012. Shooting really smooth. The balance valve in the front allows a really nice shot, smooth shot, Rich Telford, Thomas Taylor, we all love it. Definitely worth checking out.
Very good. And it's very light. I know you guys can't feel it at home, but it's super light. It's extremely thin, and this new grip frame just fits my hand perfectly. This is badass, dude. I think I would like to try taking one of these out and play. Now, with my gun, I need a new pair of goggles, and something else caught my eye. I want to show you these.
Obviously, JT is known for the Super Pro Flex, so why not update these with two new colors, new straps, very retro, bringing the retro straps back. These are going to be hot this coming year.
I swear I have exact same shirt that has this pattern on. I know I'm going to dig it out of my closet and find it. These are badass. So guys, check it out. The new JT goggle straps, colorways, and the new Impulse.
What are you doing, Matt?
I don't know. What are you doing?
Videotaping.
Is this a Mexican standoff?
I think so.
But we're going to do studio.
All right,
Matt's
here we
waving
are.
At us. You're on, you're on. See, when you leave the comfort of a beautiful
well,
studio.
Well, our studio lights aren't coming on. The green light, the red light, quiet, videos.
Well,
stuff.
We know when it's on, the camera time is when the makeup person pats your head once more and walks away. Then we know we're live.
We're also getting the hurry up signal from the guy running the Academy Awards.
So, great. I love the Impulse. I have to say, in pictures it was neat, but in person, one of the more comfortable grip frames I felt this weekend. So check that out. Now,
Todd and Matt shared a room as well, so when he talked about grip frames, ding.
Why don't we move over to the studio audience on that note. A-Train, let's talk to another guest of our studio. What is their favorite thing they saw at the show?
Well, we here with us, we have the provincial princess of paintball, Lady Justice herself, Miss Pebble.
Hello. What I found interesting was the Laporte Skeet Shooter. Launches discs and you shoot limestone pellets at it, and nice mess to not clean
it was
up.
It was interesting to see that because it launched for target practice and it would roll them, and they actually had a neat demonstration of how it could be used in tournament paintball and actually for target practice.
Yeah, you could set the height, the speed, indoor, outdoor. Pretty neat.
It was really diverse, Todd, so everybody has an opinion.
Very good. Now, for those of you that don't know, A-Train was asked to do this evening, but he forgot to wear his sports coat. So next time when he does that, he will have the sports coat.
I do
coat
get a
and the proper,
demerit
the
on the dress
long
code.
Bob Barker microphone. Joe, what do we got coming up next?
We have GOG coming up. We talked to, what's his speedball guy? Tim Montresor. And then we talked to Sergey from Lapco Paintball about some of his new stuff.
Nice.
So those videos are coming up.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Todd Ansich here for Behind the Bunker. We are at Paintball Extravaganza 2013. We are at the GOG booth with my friend Tim Montresor. How are you, sir?
Doing all right. How are you?
Good. Now, Tim's leaving for Thailand in about 15 minutes because, well, that's just the life of a GOG salesperson.
That's what we do.
But before he goes, he wanted to show us what he has here at his booth that's new and exciting. So what do you got?
Well, let me give you a quick rundown of all the products that we have.
First off, we have our G1 electronic marker. It's our milsim. Comes with three different firing modes. Then from there, we can move on to our Ecstasy. This is our high-end electronic gun. Comes with the anti-chop eyes, double trigger, walking feed neck. We also have our Envy, right? This is our entry-level electronic gun. Okay, comes with the double trigger, walking feed neck as well, dual gas regulator. But most importantly for this show and for us as a company, we have our new enemy marker right here. This is our fully pneumatic, fully mechanical spool valve, right? We created our own valve. So what we did is internally, you still have the performance of a high-end gun. So internally, it's the same as an Ion, as the Envy, as the Ecstasy, except the bottom half is fully mechanical. So we created our own three-way valve, similar to the original autococker, right? Except we simplified it. So now it's just three pieces. Inside you have armature that opens it up, redirects the air, operates it just like an electronic solenoid, except now you have the trigger, right? Which is connected to a spring that has a firing pin that opens the solenoid mechanically. So even though it seems like it's old technology, it's actually something that's never been done before, and it's done really well for us. A lot of fields and stores have taken a huge interest in this, and we offer a lifetime warranty. So you have any problems with it, broken feed neck, broken grip frame, we take care of it for life.
Yeah. I gotta be honest with you, I've fired this before, and this trigger is the lightest trigger I've felt on a mechanical marker.
2 pounds.
It's pretty awesome.
2 pounds, about 1/4 of its standard blowback.
Yeah, very cool. So check that out, guys. Now, Tim, it's great that you've made all these advances in this gun and all that, but what do you think about my electronic mobile camera here that keeps moving on? I have it on my hydraulic track. It's got very smooth tracking.
I can't believe that you guys actually could afford the budget for that.
Yeah, see, our boom even goes sideways. So check it out, guys. This is the new Enemy from GOG.
Behind the bunker, we're here at the Lavka booth. We're here with Sergey, and we're looking at the brand new 2013 Grey Ghost Open Class and Stock Class paintball marker. Sergey is going to tell you a little about them. And
well, after overwhelming demand, we've decided to finally make a Stock Class Ghost in black.
This is no longer the Grey Ghost. This is the black classic Ghost.
There we go.
It's like a Model T.
Exactly. Available in any color you like, so long as it's black. And this is the open class, since we've had so many requests to make an open class gun.
Anything special about this other than it's Lapco and it's absolutely fantastic?
It's really light.
It's very light. This is incredibly light. It almost feels like I'm holding an offshore-made product, but anybody that knows Lapco knows it's all made domestically in the U.S., on CNC machines run by elves that make things that go pew pew.
I think we go bang bang.
Bang bang.
Quite loud.
More loud, a little louder. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. See you next time. Behind the bunker.
Hey guys, Todd Anstis here, back for another Behind the Bunker segment at Paintball Extravaganza Live 2013. I like shiny things, especially little shiny candies, and I walked by the GI booth and I saw these. These are the new vapor guns. Steve, tell me about the vapor guns. What do you know? They're, other than the fact that they're shiny and new,
they look real pretty.
They sure do.
The machine vapor, I'm going with the purple one because kind of like the purple color here. With the machine vapor here, they're all milled one piece feed neck. So a lot of markers out there, they have where the feed necks aren't attached, like put together like this, and they break off a lot. Machine vapor, that's a big advantage with the machine vapor, is that the feed necks all milled in. Easy to get the bolt off here, pull it right out, lube it up, put it back in, turn it, ready to play paintball again. So, machine vapor, Scuba Steve, number 9, Paintball Extravaganza 2013.
I like the green. Now, the only thing it needs is a little laser etching of the Behind the Bunker logo on there, and we'd be all set. So, guys, check them out. New vapor.
What are you doing, Zuby?
Making a Todd dessert for lunch.
It's a shame when Zuby comes all the way here to the buffet and can't find anything to eat.
All right, so I gotta be honest with you, that's a really cool video, but I didn't get a chance to see the Grey Ghost. What?
It was... Zuby and I did the video. It was really well done, really light. It came in two configurations.
It's not the Grey Ghost anymore, is it?
Oh, no, it's not the Grey Ghost. It's now the Black Shadow, but it is on the Grey Ghost frame. did a really good job, really.
It's very nice.
Reminded me of a Carter comp gun when Aaron Carter was making them in the back room of Dye on his old machines. Really well done, really stable. And he also, Clint asked on the forum, they are bringing back the Otto Cocker bodies, so they're going to start producing. They have some milled sample bodies.
They look fantastic.
They look really good. So
very good.
Very nice.
Now, I will say that in the Twitter, go chase traffic.
From traffic cam.
Yes, has said that why isn't anybody making a hopper that's designed after my hair? We did see that. We just didn't get a video.
It did come with a bowl of pasta as well.
If you guys have any comments or concerns, put it on your Twitter feed, at Behind the Bunker, and we'll read it on the show. Why don't we go quickly over to our studio audience and see what A-Train has for us. A-Train, who are you talking to over there?
Well, I'm actually talking with everybody. Is everybody enjoying the show still?
Yeah.
Outstanding. And we're asking, what are some of the highlights of Paintball Extravaganza? And Mike from Brazil, this is your first time even hearing about the show?
No, it was the second time. I was here last year.
And you've heard about Behind the Bunker then? Have you seen it?
No, I heard about Behind the Bunker about 3 months ago. Three, 4 months ago.
Well, fantastic. Well, now you get to be part of the live studio audience. And you were here in our nation's capital for Paintball Extravaganza. What were some of the things that stood out as a highlight for you that you'll take back to Brazil?
I'm taking back very little things, but the highlight I see was the thing that makes you dance, the laser tag.
Yeah, I'd rather not talk about that. No, that was from Tippmann.
Yeah, that was from Tippmann.
Did you strap it on? Then I don't want to hear about it.
I did. I had a girl.
I saw a girl dance, and they told me you danced very well.
It was interesting. It was for, can you describe it for what it was?
Well, it was a belt which you put on, and that somebody shoots you. You use a vest with tags on it. And the minute you're hit, you get your shot, and you start to dance. So they'll hit you the second time. The more they hit you, the more you dance.
Back to you, Todd.
Very good. Well, you know what? Speaking of the taser videos, I hate to say it, but we subjected some of the people on the panel to that, and you'll see some videos coming up very shortly on it. I want to go over to our Twitter feed right now. Teachnig on Twitter just asked, are we going to see any footage of the Ego LV1? Why, yes, we are, and that is coming up very shortly, so stay tuned. But right now, we have a couple other videos to get to. Zuby, what's coming up next?
Coming up next, we have...
Reach.
Game face? Hey guys, Todd Ansett here, back from Behind the Bunker. We are still at Paintball Extravaganza 2013. I am in the HK booth with my friend. What do you say? What do you got that's new and exciting and fun for all of our HK viewers?
What's up, Behind the Bunkers? Mr. H reporting live from Paintball Extravaganza. But we have a few new items here. We're just releasing our brand new HK Army Air Tank. It's coming in two different colorways. No one's really seen this yet, so you guys are getting the first look if you want to come this way.
Nice!
So we have... They're going to be in 68-45 and 45-45. It's coming in the two styles. We got the black and gray static, and then we're going to have, you know, the more colorful option here. But we have our own reg on this. And as you can see here, you can change the colors accordingly to match with your tank or your gun or whatever. So this cool little strip right here.
So the carpet will match the drapes.
Exactly. So
very
you can
nice.
Switch that up. And it's comes high pressure, but we have low pressure springs coming with this as well. So this is kind of like our new thing that we're releasing here. We're getting some good feedback out here. So
for those people that collect HK, this is something that's going to have to be on your list.
Yeah, you're going to have to grab this bad boy. Also, we have our ball breakers, which we were just talking about.
Ouch.
Right here, these bad boys. What we did, which no one's really seen, is I cut one open here. So you can actually see exactly what breaks the paintball and keeps this safer.
Very good.
When you are playing paintball and it lasts long and it's durable, and you are able to just wash it out if you do break a ball, dry it out real quick and put it back on.
Very good. Reusable.
Yep.
Nice.
Not too shabby. And then what we have here actually is, well, this is another thing I want to show you. These are our 2013 jersey line. This is what Dynasty will be using that we're sponsoring all year long. This has a new different cut to it, a new different style, some different materials. A little bit more padding and some extra gloves, but these are our new jerseys, and we're doing this for the custom teams as well. And then last but not least, our backpacks are finally here and shipping. So our gator skin backpack, yeah, I'm going to pick that up. It's that gator skin with the gold zippers, a pretty cool little trendy backpack, a little bit different. This bad boy's here.
For the weekend in Vegas.
Yeah, the weekend in Vegas or at the paintball field, you want to strap your gun up. Either one, it works for it.
Very good. Very cool. So check it out, guys. HK Paintball. Check them out on the web or at any of the big tournaments in the area.
Appreciate it, guys. Thanks.
Hi, I'm Ray with Ninja, coming at you from the Paintball Extravaganza. Here I have my new 35 cubic inch 3000 PSI system. The nice thing about this system is it's about an inch and a half shorter than the 48. What does that mean? Yes, you get less shots, but it's more comfortable. When I put this on a gun and hold it, instead of being out here, I'm here. It's more comfortable, shorter, easier to handle, easier to shoot. Made for those young players, those young women, those people who don't want to reach out that far, have a heavy setup, this is going to lighten it up for them, make them have a better time playing, guys.
All right, hang on a sec.
You can do it, Joe.
What is this actually called?
It's called the Stress Belt. IR Tactical High Combat is the name of the game.
All right, Stress Belt, it means it hurts.
All right, guys, Joe, get started again. Stop.
Just go. We'll edit it out later.
Joe at Behind the Bunker at Paintball Extravaganza, Tippmann's temporary world headquarters here in Leesville, Virginia. And I've got the Stress Belt on by IR Tactical. I'm going to get shot. It's on the highest setting. Hopefully it will be good. Shoot me. Wow, that's going to cause a ding, 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 ding on the behind the bunker. Wow.
All right. So Joe got tased. He still has the bruises to show it.
It's still tingling sensation, but not in my loins. But it still feels like I got shocked by 4,500 watts for 2 seconds or volts or whatever. But I don't know if I'd want to be an IR regular and get lit up by the IR taser, but.
Yeah. Show of hands in the studio audience. How many of you guys got tased this week? That's it. Oh, we may need to break that bad boy back out. Mm-hmm. Why don't we move on, guys? A lot of you in the Twitter feed, as I mentioned, have already asked if we went to the Planet Eclipse booth. Well, we did. Why don't we check it out and let you have a look at the new toy.
Hey guys, Todd Ansich here, back for Behind the Bunker. We're still at Extravaganza 2013. We're at the Planet Eclipse booth, and I ran into my friend Owen. Owen, how are you?
Hey Todd, how you doing?
Good. Now you have a new toy for us to see.
I do. This is the Ego LV1. It's the latest edition, high-end super gun from Planet Eclipse. You're going to notice a couple of changes straight away. No LPR. There is an LPR. It's now located just underneath the grip here. New molded surface on this grip here. No gas line. We've got an integral gas line here, so the gas comes up through the grip, through the trigger frame, and through into the reg. I'm hearing that the inside of the gun is very different as well. Low pressure, more shots, quieter operation. I haven't put it through his paces yet, Todd, but
it's just that fresh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, can I ask a question? Can I remove this and just put a regular macro fitting if I want to put on my own bottom line?
You can. This pipe actually detaches very easily. You put a plug in this end, and then you can. You do have to revert to the older style pop system.
Yeah.
So you would exchange this system for the pop system, and you would run your gas line straight through into the Instagram.
Very good. Very slick. Nice color.
Beautiful color. 6 available. They are on display here at the Extravaganza. And we're very excited about this. Very different looking gun. Probably the most different looking Ego so far.
Yeah, I gotta say I really like the missing LPR, as it were.
It is.
It holds differently. Very cool. So check that out, guys. Planet Eclipse, the new Geo. Ego.
Good day, mate. Hi guys, Joe from Behind the Bunker. We're at Paintball Extravaganza. We're here with Eric in the Mac Dev booth. He's got a couple products he's going to show us.
Hey guys, Eric from Mac Dev. This year for 2013 at Paintball Extravaganza, we're releasing our brand new GTI for the Clone GTs. Our GTI is actually our brand new board that we just came out with. Full color LED, Bluetooth compatible, completely upgradable. Anybody who wants to come in, our home screen, you can actually customize it to your team name, anything you want to do. Set your tones, pressure readings inside the board. So no more manual gauges, everything is written right off the actual LED screen. So testing, any diagnostics, you can do right off this new board from MacDev.
Awesome. Leave it to the Australians for coming up with Bluetooth compatible. Next, you're going to have heads-up displays on your kangaroos and stuff. Awesome. It's the GTI board from MacDev.
Is he on time?
Yeah, but that's controlled through the box.
Wait.
It doesn't matter what it says on there. It's all on there.
Oh, shoot him! Shoot him!
Wait. In my shade.
Hold up.
It's on.
Hold
on.
Ready?
Hold on.
One second. Do the pose, the H pose.
Ready? Hey, throw the H's up. What are you doing?
Fuck that, dude. Just do it.
All right, Nobby, where are you at?
How's this legal?
All right, so as you can see, guys, anyone who comes to Paintball Extravaganza here in Leesburg, Virginia. Sorry,
they're changing the name from Extravaganza to
Here's the problem. We all got tased, and that was my point. When you come here through Extravaganza, the only way in is to try the tasing video or to get a tasing video done, and that's why we're all a little off tonight. So.
Washington's a shocking experience.
Very nice.
The slow hand.
Why don't we?
Yeah.
We're in Washington. We didn't bring the slow clap. We are going to go to the studio audience. Let's see A-Train and see what who he has in the audience now.
This is A-Train. I'm back in the live studio audience. Are you guys still enjoying the show?
Yeah.
Fantastic. We're here live watching Behind the Bunker, and I have caught up with Ontario's own from the Paintball Weasels, and that's D5, right?
D5 for life.
Outstanding. No need to move up.
No. Bag full of trophies, not moving up.
Fantastic. Sarge, you stayed here for 3 days. You got to experience our nation's capital and all that is Paintball Extravaganza.
And all that is American food.
Sorry about that. But we will definitely give you a few memories to take back, good or bad. What were some of the things that really stood out for you? Paintball is your life.
It's my life.
What stood out this year for 2013?
I got to hang out with Bob and Zach for a bit, check out the VCOM.
From Bob Long?
Bob Long VCOM, yep. The two engines, so you get the spool and the inline poppet with it. It's compatible with the Ripper. So if you have an existing Ripper, just go grab the new engine and put it in, and it'll work.
Well, you're kind of a gearhead and a gun collector, correct?
Yeah, a bit of a gun whore, yeah.
Nice. And any rumor that one of those, they just launched.
They just launched, yeah.
Just launched. Any rumor that one of those will be going north?
Yes. I did see a white and blue one heading to Canada. So you might see that in someone's hands very soon.
Maybe. So all Canadians, be on the lookout. There's the new marker from Bob Long coming at you. And if you have any questions, you can get with Sarge from the Paintball Weasels and Aaron's Army.
Aaron's Army.
I'll send you back to you, Todd.
Very nice. So very cool. We're going to move on, guys. We have lots more to get to yet tonight. Up next, I get to stop in at the NXZ booth and see what's new there.
I rappel into Rap 4 to look at some of the MagFed stuff. What do you got?
Well, just like Tomcat, I got nothing.
No, that's okay.
We had some issues with the
frame. Hey guys, Todd Ensich here live at Paintball Extravaganza 2013 for Behind the Bunker. I'm in the Tippmann booth. Although it doesn't look like Tippmann, this is the NXC part of their booth, guys. I've always been a big fan of the NXC pod packs, and Ron's going to show me a little bit about the new pod pack.
Okay, our new Elevation series has been upgraded. One of the biggest features, we've added a much stronger lumbar support. It feels great on your back. It's non-slip. It just stays on there. It gives you a good feel on your back. We've also made it a little bit lighter, so it actually feels good. It's a little bit lighter to carry around. It still features the full body wrap strap. We've added a couple nice little things where you can have a little packet for, put your money in through there, your valuables into that side, on that side of it. And then also, it still features, the friction reduce pod injectors. We've got an upgraded rubber pull on that side of it. We have it in two configurations. We have it in a 4+3+2 or a 3+2+2. And also, it's available in three different colors. A lot of varieties there for you. We've upgraded the whole look, upgraded the performance. I think you're going to like this harness.
Yeah. Now, the one downside about NXC pod packs, and I will tell you this, if you always want to be on the latest and greatest, this is not the one for you, because you will buy this pod pack like I do, and you will be wearing it for years and years and years. I have an Elevation
harness that I have that's probably 3 years old. And although it doesn't look brand new, everything still works on it. The Velcro is great. None of the stitching's come loose. So guys, if you're looking for a quality pack, I gotta be honest with you, this is the one that I've been wearing. So check it out.
16 bucks a piece, they come apart.
Hi there, I'm Joe from Behind the Bunker. We're at Paintball Extravaganza 2013 in somewhere in Virginia. This is Omar Macy from Rap 4, and he's gonna tell us about the new Rap 4 468.
All right. Well, again, the 468 is basically an M4 style marker. It was primarily developed for military training, but what we're seeing, anything that applies to military training really helps and spills over to Milsim paintball. This is the 468 configured with the D-Mag. This is a 20-round D-Mag on it, and we'll get all into how this works, basically the details behind it. There's a trap system in here that's really neat, a lock bolt system that has virtually eliminated 99% of the chops. It's basically a set of mechanical eyes. Again, basically upper and lower receiver system has a very good weight and balance to the actual M4 selector on it. I mean, the thing is actually really close. It's a one-to-one training tool. All right. D-Mags, of course, long and awaited. I know some of you have mentioned these.
Next week.
Actually, just so you know, D-Mags have gone live as of last night. They are for sale for
1 week early.
They are for sale for some of the platforms, such as the Phenom kit or the MKP or MKP2, which is now the newest generation of it made here in the U.S.
What's the cost on D-Mags?
D-Mags right now, I believe they're $58.95 for a pack of 10, so they're under $6 per mag.
It's a good price.
I mean, it's fair. Very fair, about the price of a high-end pod out there. And of course, the whole idea behind this is you treat them just like a pod. You go for your first round, go shoot your 10 rounds, turn around, flip it, shoot your second 10 rounds, drop it, get your next mag, and keep on shooting.
Pew, pew, shoot bad guys.
Indeed. Don't worry about it. Pick it up later, label it, put stickers on it, whatever you got to do, but keep on shooting. Don't get stuck in a situation where you're getting shot because you're fumbling around trying to put your mags in the way. And that's what we've seen in training, and that's the whole reason behind the D-Mag, and that's why it was developed. It's such a low cost, so you can treat it like a pod and keep on shooting. That's basically the idea.
Awesome.
Again, the 468 with the D-Mag. Okay, let me get a couple. Upper and lower receiver system. Okay. Firing control group is down at the bottom here. Now, we're fully aired up here, so definitely if you are going to be working on this marker, get a certification from RAP4. Make sure that you're doing this properly, because since this is a new boundary that we're stepping on here, there is no other marker you can completely disassemble while it's aired up. You definitely want to use it properly and be sure nobody gets hurt, because that will basically make this thing be not operational if it's aired up.
So this is very real steel, guys. Get into your Humvee, drive down to RAP4 and get some training.
Indeed. All right, so you want to change your upper receiver. Let's say you have another upper receiver with a different barrel length, different optics. You don't have to worry about going into your toolbox and taking everything apart. You basically have one lower receiver and as many upper receivers you want in different configurations.
Awesome. They're all available and will be available and interchangeable.
Correct, correct.
Like Lego, same cool factor as well.
Indeed, so you don't have to worry about that anymore. To gain access to your bore, you just remove the bolt and bolt carrier. Now you have full access all the way down the bore. You can clean it, do whatever you got to do with it, and not have to worry about it. So I would say in under 10 seconds, you're able to run a squeegee down this thing. There's only two active O-rings or seals throughout this whole system. One's on the striker in the front, which catches a blowback, and the other one's a poppet. That's all it is. All these other O-rings that they have, there's different variations of the bolt. This one has two, there's another one that has three O-rings, and those are just for better efficiency, but they're not needed for the functioning of the marker. Right. So, again, close this up. This thing is ready to shoot again. All right, something else. This has a trap system, has a mechanism in place, so it does not allow rounds to fall out. So you can do a mag check in the middle of the game or middle scenario. So you take your mag out, take it out, see if you have rounds, put it back in there, and continue to shoot. Any other MagFed system that we have or we've produced, or most of the ones that are around, if you take out the magazine before it shoots, you will basically lose the rounds.
Awesome. Sounds good. Thank you very much, Omar, and we'll see you soon.
Dang it! She keeps shooting. Dang. Are you kidding me? Did you see my face?
No, we didn't.
It's crazy. Thank God.
All right, so well done. In the Skype, we had, who was his name? Temp Bacon wanted to know if HK Army's red pants, skinny jeans, were for sale. You can actually get them at his booth. They're $89.99, but it's not a material. It's actually a paint-on. So yes. Check them out at the next time you're at an event. A-Train, in our studio audience, you are, who do you have beside you now?
Well, I'm actually here with Jason Patrick from the Citrus Connection, a good friend of the show. How are you today, Jason?
I'm great, thanks.
Wonderful. Now, at Paintball Extravaganza, not only do they have the trade show going on, but they also have the... Did you lose something? Drop your pocket. You okay? You mad, bro?
All good.
All right. They have the education seminars and technical classes. You got to participate in some of those?
Yeah, I did Virtue this morning on their new loader.
Outstanding. Now, can you describe a little bit about what those technical classes that they offer here at Paintball Extravaganza are?
They're great classes from the ground up. Get to see what the new products are, common quirks, features. It's great.
And in most of the classes, you actually get to walk away with?
You walk away with the product.
So there were people walking, say, when they went to the dye class.
If you went to the dye class, you came out with a DM13 and the new dye dam.
Nice. Hoo-yah.
Nice.
Very cool. Very cool. Yeah. Well, guys, we have tons more to get to. Also, I want to mention Bowman70 Derek Twittered us and said, hey, guys, keep plugging the Made in America. Love it. It's really nice to see all the companies that are still making and manufacturing stuff in America. I am going to move on. We have another video to get to. I go and check out the G36. And what do you do?
I go to Virtue and we check out some of their new private label Spires.
Very good. And Zuby has lunch. Surprise, surprise. Check it out.
Hey guys, Todd Ansich here. I'm still at Paintball Extravaganza 2013. I'm in the Empire BT booth, and I want to show you a couple things that I saw. You guys know the TM15, not a new product, but what they do have is some limited colors here. Okay, so check these out. We also have this bad boy down here. But what the most important thing is that I found in the booth is the new BT4 G36. This is the G36 Elite. And Paul, what do you have in your hand?
I have the G36. The G36 is the newest line for our Empire Battle Tested line. We've expanded on the slice platform. As you can see, we've added a folding stock, which is pretty cool. Easy snaps in place. You have a raised sight rail that goes all the way across. Of course, the extended foregrip and barrel to give it that G36 look. And you have all the Picatinny rails so you can mount all the cool stuff, flashlights.
That is a whole lot of Picatinny goodness on there.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome. And then, like you said, with the Elite, you get the... The Elite, you get the electronic double trigger finger. You get the Apex 2 barrel. And it also comes with the rip clip feed system. So it's a complete system. Again, you have the folding stock. Pretty neat. You just slide it down, fold it forward. All the Picatinny love, like you said. And we're pretty excited about it. Like I said, expanding on this slice platform with the G36 and the G36 Elite.
Yeah, for sure. Now, this is the only gun that I've seen at Paintball Extravaganza that has, not only has the most square footage of Picatinny, but it has a double level of Picatinny. So it's all about the Picatinny. So cool, guys. So if you would like something badass like this, this is the new BT G36.
Thank you.
Hi guys, Joe from Behind the Bunker. We're here at Paintball Extravaganza 2013. We're in the Virtue Paintball booth, and we're here with Chris. He's going to talk about their new for 2013 products.
This is new at the trade show. We don't believe in new for 2013. We have new multiple times in 2013. Okay, but here at the Extravaganza, we're releasing a new product here. We've got Russian Legion Edition Spires, Impact Edition Spires. We signed these two top teams, and we wanted to give them something a little bit special. We're excited to work with these guys. They're both going to be killing it in the PSP this year. The Russian Legion one, we've got, it's a dark navy shell. So it's got a dark navy shell with the red accents and then the Russian Legion badge in place of the Spire badge. It comes with the Crown SF speed feed as stock, and it also has the lid as well. So you get it here, you get the speed feed on it, and you actually get the lid as well on the Russian Legion one. Same with the Impact one. It's called the Impact one out here. It's a dark brown. It's a dark brown with like another dark brown on the lid. Impact, their colors are brown and kind of a little bit of gold. They really like this dark brown. The lighting in here maybe looks a little bit, you know, almost looks a little bit black. When you get out in the sunlight, you can see it is definitely brown, but it is a darker brown, like a nice dark brown, so it doesn't really stick out. Here we've also added, actually, we've added the pinks. This was by popular demand. We got pink and black, and pink and white here. Let me just step right over here. Pink and white right here. So pink and black and pink and white. We had a lot of people requesting that, so we came out with these. To avoid sort of like skew bloat on the store side of things, we are discontinuing pretty much, or we're not making any more of the oranges or the yellows. If there's any yellows here, the yellows right here. And those are just kind of like, you know, we figured if we're going to add some new products, we don't want to basically like load people too much on too many SKUs, so we're dropping off a couple at the same time. So if there's any oranges and yellows out there, get them while you can, because they're not going to last.
So for Red Dawn, we have the Russian Legion version, and if you're watching hockey in Edmonton, you've got the brown, or it's sort of like an Oakley root beer color from back in the days of retroness. So good stuff. Root beer free, root beer iridium. So thanks to Chris from Virtue for showing us his new stuff.
This is Josh saying, but I'm not hungry, I'll just grab a small snack.
There's only one food group there.
Awesome.
All right, so pretty cool. Pretty cool. You know what? I have to say that this is the first extravaganza that seems to have this many paintball markers being released. We have Planet
Eclipse. A lot of markers.
We have Empire has four. We have, help me out, Scarab.
Scarab.
We have T-15.
Tiberius.
Milsim.
Milsim. No.
There's
RAP4,
I'm sorry. So there's tons of stuff. There's tons of stuff.
Maybe
and we
one
still
from
have
Vanguard?
A lot more to get to. Up next, we have video from Tippmann that has a newly upgraded gun and a rental marker we'll see. But before we do that, why don't we move over to our studio audience and see who Track 21 A-Train has.
Outstanding. I'm here with local... I don't know what to... Local
Legend.
Paintballer.
Legend.
Well, behind the bunker.
Contributor.
Contributor. Beaker.
Hey, guys.
Well, we're glad to be here. And you had an interesting job. You ran security.
Yes.
Okay.
Security.
Now, I got a little chirped, as I usually do, on the internet about not having barrel bags. And that was kind of floating around in social media. And safety here. And I wanted to address this with you because we had a different perspective. Why was this kind of allowed this weekend, and normally we'd send out the barrel bag police,
right? Which we usually would do that for this show. It was only for industry people, and we also had the painstaking job of going through each tank, making sure they were all bled. There was no air allowed into the show whatsoever.
You think the TSA is bad? Try to get a once over from Beaker.
For sure. Now I'm going to interject here for a second, A-Train. I would like to know. I know Beaker is a regular watcher of the show. And I heard the other day that his biggest fan was Dustin, and I just put two and two together. Is that a Dustin stash I see?
Is that a Dustin stash? I think it's a fair question.
Is that some homage to Dustin?
Actually, I've had this for, like, the only thing I can grow, because I can't grow anything else. So, yeah, I guess you could say it was an homage to Dustin, too, as well. So
you're a shower, not a grower. Why don't we move on and go and check out Tippmann? They have a new updated marker, so check it out, and we'll be right back, guys.
Hey guys, Todd Ansich for another edition of Behind the Bunker. We are here live at Paintball Extravaganza, not here with my friend Nick. We are here with my friend Ron, and he has a new upgrade for this marker. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, I've got the new TPN Bravo 1 Elite. The TPN line has been extremely successful over the last few years, and the Bravo 1 has been a very strong seller. What we wanted to do is kind of take it up a notch, so we have the new Bravo 1 Elite. And it features a lot of different things for your fans and for the players. First of all, we have a removable handle. It also has a new shroud with a Picatinny rail. We separated it out the front sight. And plus it has a stock that has six different steps that you can go with. It also has a magazine. Inside the magazine, you can actually put a toolkit in there. So it's all complete package. It has a brand new look from the old Bravo 1 for the Bravo 1 Elite. And then, best of all, it also now is able to take the
response trigger. So when you add the response trigger, the cyclone feed system, you can have a milsim look that can shoot over 15 balls per second, and it doesn't need batteries. And best of all, the whole thing, we've kept the price where it was before.
And that's awesome. Now, guys, to reiterate Ron's point, you're looking for a milsim-looking gun. Not only can you take this off, and you can put on your scopes, whatever that you want, your sights. With the Picatinny rail underneath here, you can put on your tactical flashlights, your lasers, anything like that. So a little more options, especially now that you can put the response trigger in. So check this out, guys. This is the newly upgraded package for the Tippmann Bravo 1 Elite.
Hi, guys. Joe at Behind the Bunker. We're here at the Vulcan booth with Vulcan Greg, and he's going to show us one of their new products.
How's it going? We got the new RM1 rental marker. Features of this include an integrated barrel cover. Goes on the grip when it's on the field. We also have 4 push pins. No screws, no wasted time. Rear cocking, integrated. Nice and clean, wipe it down at the end of the day. Oil port. Removable feed neck. Easy clean out. We're gonna squeegee right through. And then we have the velocity port. And a true ball detent, not rubber fingers.
True ball detent.
That's right.
Awesome. This comes in 2 feed necks, clamping and Allen key bolt type, correct?
That's correct.
Tell us a little bit about your new loader.
New loader. Well, it's 240 balls, extra super tough. Large neck will fit a whole pod.
Or one handful of rocks if you're a rental player. Rocks and grass will go in here nicely. But the innovative feed neck port will allow quick cleaning from Vulcan. Thanks, guys. See you next time. You've been watching Behind the Bunker.
Tell me who you are and what do you watch?
Mike Redgowski, GI Sports, baby.
What do you watch on Mondays?
Oh, hold on with Eugene. Hey, Eugene, can I call you right back? Okay. Behind the Bunker, man. What do you think?
This is far more important than any phone call to Eugene.
Behind the Bunker, what do you think?
Nah.
So here's a comparison for you. We have Zuby
with his little tiny taste for breakfast.
Just a little sweet bite.
And Joe.
That's how I keep lean and spelt and able to go pew pew.
It's a whole lot of Zuby going in there.
All right, so we're back. So we have a lot more to get to. And as I say, tonight we are doing a live broadcast from Leesburg, Virginia at Paintball Extravaganza. We have toured the facility, saw all kinds of great stuff, and we are putting it all together for you guys to see. So everything that's new and fancy, you will see. Anything that we miss, because of time, we will push onto our next couple weeks show. So stay tuned and you'll see all of that. This show is also airing back in YouTube. In about an hour or two after the show, it'll be uploaded to YouTube so you can watch it, share it, and do whatever you wish with it. Now,
or watch and share.
We also watch and share. Now, we also have a live studio audience, guys, and in our live studio audience, we have A-Train. A-Train, do you have anyone for us to talk to?
Todd, at this time, the majority has voted that we have no comment.
All right, apparently our studio audience has turned on us, literally. So why don't we move on, guys? We have lots more to get to.
I think
up next,
in America, it's called their Fifth Amendment.
I believe
right.
They are
Fifth
pleading the Fifth.
Pleading the Fifth.
So up next, guys, we are going to see LASIK. Joe, yes. You went and talked to the guys at
LASIK. I talked to LASIK.
And we're going to go over to Vanguard and see our friend Frank Connell. So stay tuned. We'll be right back, guys.
Hi, guys. Joe from Behind the Bunker. We're at Paintball Extravaganza 2013. I'm in the LASIK booth here. It's an English company distributed in Germany with Kiwi roots, manufactured in Asia by people younger than myself, but their stuff is cool. They do customized pants, different colors, different patterns. You can customize it. Great for stores, great for teams. They have a 10 pair minimum. They have several different SKUs. You can modify it, customize it in any way. Just look at some of their design features, hidden pocket, flaps with Velcro. The one favorite of mine is this pant with the ID tag. So instead of carrying your player's card on a lanyard, pull it out, pew, and it's even in purple. Purple is the navy of the 90s. This Kiwi invented magnetic pack, no Velcro, magnets These are super strong earth magnets. They're found around where they filmed Lord of the Rings in New Zealand. Awesome stuff. They're tanked covers, very innovative, very fantastic. You can peel it off like this. So if you have to show someone your hydro, it's much like a kiwi. Comes apart, fruits inside, very sweet nectar. Check your stuff. You can mix and match, modify, great packs. Check out LASIK on the web. Guys, you've been watching Behind the Bunker. See you next time.
Okay, guys, Todd Ansich here from Behind the Bunker. We're at Paintball Extravaganza 2013, and I ran into my friend Frank the Tank Connell. How are you, sir?
Pretty good. How you doing?
Not too bad. Vanguard. Tell me about it. Why should we come to the Vanguard booth?
Why should you come to the Vanguard booth? That's a simple question. Because of the Vanguard Demon. Hottest marker on the market today. Works off a 90 PSI OLED board, as you can see right here. Very nice and visual effects, so you can change modes very, very quickly. You don't have to worry about sounds. You don't have to worry about different colors. All you got to do is be able to read, to change everything from your modes, to go to PSP, Millennium, ramping, you know, semi-auto, change your rate of fire just by pressing a button. So it's pretty simple, really easy to work with. You're getting about, out of 16,4500, you get about 1,750 shots.
Wow, very cool. And this is a new edition, the Avalanche?
The Avalanche edition is our Pro Series one. We do have a stock Demon, but the Avalanche is just a milling in the side, different foregrip and everything else.
Very nice. But, now, as you mentioned, we were just talking off camera, the Behind the Bunker Anodize is coming out next month, I hear.
Yes, it is.
Very good. Cool. So where do we find more information about the Vanguard?
Go to www.vanguardpaintballusa.com.
Jay of Empire Paintball, you're watching Behind the Bunker.
All right, very cool. Now, live in studio, as we said, we have a studio audience, but we just happen to have Mr. Frank the Tank Connell from Vanguard Paintball. A-Train.
Yes.
Can we talk to Frank?
Outstanding. Here we go.
Stanza?
Can you get us on the live feed? Yep, we got you here. Yep, they're coming in. Can you hear?
Wait. Before we start this interview, you got to take a breath, man, because that's bad. Okay, let's go ahead.
Frank the Tank Connell from New England Avalanche, NPPL, legend of the game, and the owner of Vanguard USA. How was Paintball Extravaganza for you?
I have to say, it was a really good event. You know, I got to see a lot of friends, you know, a lot of people out there, and it was just, it was amazing. I can't, you know, the people that were here, the customers are here, all my friends that I spent time with, you know, Behind the Bunker guys, everybody, we had a blast.
That's outstanding. Now, as an industry insider, there's someone in the industry.
Who's that, you?
No, yourself.
Oh, sorry, me.
I'm nobody. You can't even Google me. So, as an insider, is this really just the greatest paintball opportunity, or are there more out there for networking instead of not working in your business?
You know what? I got to say that this is a very big opportunity to meet a lot of business owners and a lot of field owners and store owners and everything else. But every day going to the paintball field and playing paintball is networking, the way I look at it, and promoting.
Wow. See, we heard it from Frank Connell himself. Everyday play, just being interactive and getting out and meeting the players and field owners and staying a community is what's driving the business.
Very cool. Very cool. Well, thanks, Frank, for being in on the show. Now, A-Train, you have someone else sitting beside you.
We have beside A-Train, we have Omar. He's the head engineer at RAP4 in California.
Nice to meet you, Omar. Welcome to the studio.
He's going to talk about the new release of his...
Well,
we
do have
markers.
Some questions that did come in from some official correspondents.
All right.
And my friend Snarky wanted to know, when are the D-Mags coming?
Who's Snarky?
Some jackass. when are the D-Mags coming?
Well, D-Mags are out for the MKP, so the Phenom Mag Kit, and they'll be out for the rest of the models in the months to come.
Outstanding. Do you have a date, or are we just to wait?
We do have dates. Next big release will be our 468, which is our new flagship model, and that'll be out March 20th with the D-Mags.
So there you have it. Get off the threads, get off the forums, quit trolling. You heard it from Omar, and we're going to hold you to it.
You're going to hold me to it.
Outstanding. Back to you, Todd.
Very good. Very good. This is great. We have seen so many things so far this evening. We have lots more to get to, and I have to be honest, we've already, looking at our list, have axed a good 25% of our videos, but we are going to play them this week our Monday night show.
Would you be vanquishing them now or axing them? Sorry.
I would be discluding them. Watch on Monday. This week, we're going to add some more videos. We're going to put all this up on our YouTube channel and all over the next couple weeks. We have lots of things that we still want to show you. Up next, guys, we're going to go check out a couple more manufacturers. Check them out.
All right, guys, Paintball Extravaganza 2013. We are in the Kingman booth, the Spider booth, with my friend Owen, and we've got some neat things to show you. What do you got now?
This is the latest gun out of Kingman. It's the Hammer 7, pump action, mag fed, first strike ready.
Very cool.
And at a great price. These sell for like $129.
Well, yeah, pump guns are hot this year, as well as mag fed. So you're combining both, and you're getting them for $129. So if you want to try either of these genres, this is the perfect way to get into it. Very cool.
You just turn the barrel top to go from paint to first strike. You can add a loader right here. A tank goes right in the back. And what we're looking at here is a design that actually isn't going to be available on the marketplace for another 3 to 6 months.
So you're seeing it here first. Nice! Very cool. So check that out, guys. If you're looking for a pump and or a mag-fed situation for cheap, this is a great way to get into it. So this is the new Hammer from Spider. Hey guys, Todd Ansich back for another Behind the Bunker segment. We are still here live at Paintball Extravaganza 2013. Hey, if you're like me and you've got a small room like a studio and it's full of guys that you just need to eliminate, what better than grabbing yourself a paint grenade? Check these out. These are the new redone Big Boys.
Correct. We've redesigned. The Big Boy has been well known to be the grenade that will explode or splatter paint every single time. But what we wanted to do this time is kind of take it up to another level. So we did a couple changes to it. One, we've added more paint into it, so it's got over 10 ounces of paint. But the big thing everyone's going to notice is this new lever at the top. It's got a much more realistic look. You just push down on the lever, pull the pin, and let it fly. And when it lands, it sprays, goes down, hits up in the air, and over 30 feet of paint is splattered around the area. It's a great grenade. You're going to have a lot of fun with it, and it's available right now.
These are cool. And the realistic, guys, you got to pull the pin, release the lever, and then throw it. So check it out. These are the new Big Boys from Tippmann. Now no longer Josh will be labeled as the Big Boy. This is the Big Boy.
So, you watch Behind the Bunker. You know who I am? I'm on the show. I have my own segment. I'm on the panel. I actually sit. Well, actually, Todd sits right beside me. It's not a big deal.
And he burned. She turned and walked away. Although she was cardboard and affixed to the
I thought
wall,
she was pretty flat.
To turn
yeah, someone rolled her up and put her in a tube.
You didn't even ding me. I said I thought she was pretty flat.
Oh, I didn't even hear that. Just want to do a quick shout out. Chris Burge on Twitter says, let Omar know his mag-changing skills were amazing. We were watching your video before,
they
and they watched how you were doing it, and everybody was talking about it. So. Fantastic.
Very nice.
I want to take an opportunity, first of all, to thank the guys in the studio audience for coming down all the way to Leesburg, Virginia, just to watch Behind the Bunker live for no other reason.
Yay.
So thanks, guys. I want you guys to tell me on my... All right, so guys in the studio audience, on Monday nights, what do you guys watch?
Behind the Bunker!
Nice, nice. Very good. So guys, I want to tell you about a couple things. We are live every Monday night. If this is the first time you're watching, thank you very much. Check us out on Monday nights at behindthebunker.com. There are lots of people in our chat forum to the right of your screen if you're watching in Rewind. If you're watching on YouTube, head on over, check it out. It's a live interactive show. You can hit us up on Twitter. We're also looking at our live chat feed. Joe Kimson, Josh Zubizabrikas, Gavin Sharma, and all the rest are online every week for your viewing pleasure, so to speak. You guys can send in topic videos. You can send in your email questions. You can interact with the show at any point in time, so definitely check that out. I have a very rambunctious studio audience.
Studio audience, yes.
Very lively studio.
And I also want to say thank you very much to quote unquote Plant for making making his
special
debut.
And maybe it's Fern.
I believe his name was Fern.
His name was Fern.
So guys, thank you very much from all of us to you. Thank you very much for watching. Check us out every week at behindthebunker.com. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you on Monday night. Pew, pew.